Hello again. I haven't been on in a while, so I thought I'd get a video out there. So, well, I've just been lazy, not doing videos, or what I've been up to. Well, basically, I've been moving. I think I mentioned that before. This is the second time in 4 months I've moved. Hoping that this is a final move for a while, because moving is unpleasant. Traveling with a backpack, that's fun. Moving all the crap that you've accumulated, not so much fun. I wonder if that will get me censored. Oh, crap. So, why did I move? Well, as I think I mentioned in a couple videos, I was planning on moving to Ecuador, and, well, I did. So, why did I move to Ecuador? Bottom question, of course, if you're nomadic, is why not go to Ecuador? But this wasn't just a nomadic trip for me in this particular case. I changed my home base from the Pacific Northwest, Oregon, in the United States to Ecuador. Why would I do such a thing? Well, it's pretty simple. There's a gal on the internet. He has a catchphrase. I forget his actual name. My wife and I have a nickname for him, but he has a phrase called go where you're treated best. And that's not a bad idea. In our case, that is no longer the United States. They do not treat us the best. We are middle class, W-2 working folk, and they tax the bejeebers out of us. And despite what some political parties might say, claiming that the U.S. has some of the lowest taxes, well, that's only for companies. That's not for individuals. We are taxed to death with one of the highest tax rates in the Western world. If you don't think so, do the math. So it's pretty bad. And we get almost nothing for it. So we left. We left the U.S. to save money on taxes. Will we go back to the U.S.? Sure, probably. It's, you know, we've home-based in Ecuador, but, you know, let's face it, home is where you spend a good chunk of your life, and that's always going to be, you know, probably the Oregon area for us. So we'll go back. But right now, we're living abroad to save money. Some people think the U.S. is the greatest country on the earth. There's many ways to measure such a thing. I think the question itself is somewhat invalid. Is the country you're in the greatest country for you at that point in time? And for us, the U.S. wasn't. It's not been for a while, and we finally accepted it and we left. Will it be again at some point? Maybe. We'll go back. That's okay. The U.S. will always welcome you back as long as you know, if you go renounce your citizenship or something like that, which if you want to, great. That's pretty extreme in my opinion. But as long as you haven't done that, if you're traveling around, you left the U.S. for years, they'll welcome you back because that's your citizen. It's birthright. It's your tax money. Well, it's the tax money they want to take from you. They'll welcome you back with open arms. But if you're living abroad, you can save a lot on taxes. And I detail some of that in other videos. And that's why we decided to home base elsewhere. And Ecuador is a very nice place to home base. Hanging out on the beach in Ecuador, it's got some pretty good food. The infrastructure here is fine. I can't drink the water out of the tap, you know. Well, you can. It's a great weight loss plan, I suppose, if you want to go that route. But short of that, you don't really want to drink the tap water. But the infrastructure that I care about, I can get bottled water, but I can't get bottled internet. Internet here is great. I've got a fiber optic feed coming on my apartment. I'll probably get a second cable feed coming in too, so I have redundancy like I used to back in the States. 350 megabit, I think, is what I'm getting up and down bi-directional on fiber. Perfectly fine to hang out here for a great deal of time. So I've got some videos that are going to come out in detail the citizenship, or not, sorry, I keep saying citizenship, the residency path here in Ecuador. There's different types of visas that you can get. The one I'm going for is called a professional visa, which is a little bit more paperwork than some of the others, but once you have it, it's pretty nice. Basically, if you have a four-year college degree, you can get a professional visa. That's a four-year college degree from an accredited university that they recognize, and you did in-person learning or online learning at an in-person university with some caveats. I don't know, but I'm old, so everything was in person when I did my undergrad degree. If you get that, the pain in the neck part is registering the degree with Ecuador. But once you've got that done, then you can apply for the residency permit based off that. And that's a lot of paperwork. Hire a lawyer is my advice. You can try to do it yourself if you speak really great Spanish. I hired a lawyer. I'll let you know who she is. So far, it's working out pretty well with her, but I'm not going to put out her name or any recommendations until we are finished and I have that residency permit in hand. So there are other visas or residency permits you can get. You can get ones based off investment, and it's not a huge amount of money you have to invest. I think like $42,000 is the minimum for a single person. There's a minimal amount more for a married couple or kids or something. Perfectly fine visa if you want to get that. That ties your money here in Ecuador. You make some good return down here, so I don't see why that'd be a problem. But if you don't have to tie it, why? Which is what our thought. So I did the professional visa. Like I said, I've got some videos coming out on that. I've got a couple already on this. And again, this is just a home base change. Let's still be nomadic and travel. But, you know, I'm not the nomadic live off of backpack for years and years at a time. I like a place to come back to that's home, and or at least a home base. And that's going to be Ecuador now. And then I can still branch out and still travel around South America. So that's kind of the plan. Like I said, more videos coming out. I've also started a blog to write some of this down. I guess that's kind of old school. Everybody's doing video logs now, but you know, there's still a place for written text. And so I've started writing some of the stuff down that I've been doing. Again, double check my advice. I'm not a tax attorney. What I said today may be perfectly valid at this particular instance. Next week, it could be invalid in Ecuador. Who knows? So double check everything at the time that you wish to do something. That's about all I wanted to share today. And I'll put the blog, in the description. It's started. I got one entry into it. I'll keep adding that as I add more videos. And I'll get one out fairly quick on the first part of the process for me, which is getting the degree apostilled and down in here. I always say that word wrong, but getting the degree registered here in Oregon. I'm sorry, getting my degree registered here in Ecuador. And then as I go through the rest of the process for temporary residence, I'll detail that out as well. I hope you find these interesting, and I hope you decide maybe to evaluate your life and see if you do want to move out. I do have friends that have said, wow, I'm really shocked that you're moving. I wish I could do that. You know, most of the people that say, I wish I could do that actually could do that. They just aren't willing to take that big leap. And it's scary. You know, most big things in life are scary. But the big thing is just do it. And so I hope that more and more people just decide to just do it. Take the risk. You know, if it fails, you can always go back home. So have fun with life. I hope you find these video series interesting, and I'll be chatting more later on this. Take care. Bye.